Good morning, student. Today we are just discussing simple pendulum. Now, before knowing what is simple pendulum, let us first define what do you mean by ideal simple pendulum. Ideal simple pendulum. A heavy point mass. Heavy point mass which is suspended by heavy point mass suspended by massless heavy point mass suspended by massless inextensible massless inextensible and flexible string to a rigid support. A heavy point mass suspended by means of massless, inextensible, flexible string to a rigid support or from a rigid support is called ideal simple pendulum. Massless means mass of string is negligible as compared to that of heavy point mass. Inextensible means that string is not allowed to undergo any stretching effect. Tachi lambi vaadta kiwa kami hota kama nahi. Length of that string it remains constant. Flexible means this string ha jo dora hai it is made from multiple string. Mhanje eka peksha jast dorya eka vez ghevun tyala tilun tayar kelela jo dora asel tasa dora simple pendulum madhe vaparla jato. So, a heavy point mass suspended by means of massless, inextensible, flexible string from a rigid support is called an ideal simple pendulum. Practically, we won't have a heavy point mass. So, what practical simple pendulum consists of? A practical simple pendulum, it consists of a small but heavy, that is dense, metal sphere called as ball. It is suspended by means of inextensible string, which is flexible also, from a rigid support, and which is allowed to oscillate in a single vertical plane freely under gravity. Lakshapurva gaitun gya. A small and heavy metal ball suspended by means of inextensible string from a rigid support and which is allowed to oscillate in a single vertical plane freely under gravity is called a practical simple pendulum. Now the length of practical simple pendulum, see here, OA, it represents the equilibrium position of a simple pendulum. Means we can say this pendulum is in equilibrium position when it is at position OA. Equilibrium position means the restoring force acting on a pendulum is zero. Means if pendulum is under equilibrium condition, it does not move anywhere. So under equilibrium condition, the distance of separation between point of suspension, O is the point from where that pendulum is suspended. So, the distance of separation between point of suspension O and the center of gravity of metal ball. Center of gravity of metal ball means length of string plus radius of ball. That is nothing but length of simple pendulum and it is denoted by a letter L. So, OA is the equilibrium position of simple pendulum. Now, if I just move the pendulum, from the mean position, OA, which is equilibrium position, it is also called as mean position. If it is displaced through a small angular displacement theta, when pendulum has given a small angular displacement theta, that is pendulum reaches at one of its extreme position P, and if it is released, then we know that pendulum, it starts oscillating about its mean position A within the two extreme position B and that of C. The time taken by a pendulum To complete one oscillation means if I start counting the oscillation, pendulum moves from B to A, A to C, C to A, and from A back to B. Then we can say pendulum has completed one oscillation. Now, why pendulum starts oscillating when it is released from the extreme position? Why pendulum oscillate when it released from extreme position? Now look at the extreme position B of a pendulum. At the extreme position B, there are two forces acting on a pendulum. One of the force is tension T dash in the string, while the second force is the weight mg of a ball. Weight mg of a ball, which always acts vertically downward. It always acts vertically downward. Now this weight of a ball is resolved into two components. One of the component mg cos theta, it is along the length of string. Along the length of string. And because when we release the ball from the extreme position, it does not move along the length of string. Asaya string cha lambi cha dishin to movement karto ka nahi. It means this force, this tension in the string T dash, it must be balanced by mg cos theta. Means this T dash is equal to mg cos of theta. So the two forces which are equal in magnitude, but they are acting opposite in direction, hence they cancel the effect of each other. So at the extreme position B, now this bob is under the action of only one force, and that force is mg sine of theta. At extreme position B, the only force which is acting on a bob, it is mg sine of theta. This force is directed towards mean position. This force is directed towards what? Mean position. Any force which is directed towards mean position and which is responsible for to and fro motion of a particle, that force we call it as a restoring force. So the restoring force acting on the bob of a pendulum, it can be written as F is equal to minus mg sine of theta. Instead of writing mg sine theta, why minus mg sine theta? See here, force is directed towards the mean position and angular displacement is measured away from the mean position. Means angular displacement and force, they are oppositely directed. So that's why the restoring force acting on Restoring force acting on a pendulum is given by F is equal to minus of mg sine of theta. Minus of what? Mg sine of theta. Remember, we have to prove that the motion of simple pendulum is linear simple harmonic motion if pendulum has given a small amplitude of oscillation. Means if this theta is small, then only the motion of simple pendulum is what? Linear simple harmonic motion. But angular displacement theta or amplitude of vibration, amplitude of oscillation is small. Means what? This angle theta, definitely it is less than that of 10 degrees Celsius. And from the knowledge of mathematics, we know that sine of a smaller angle is equal to that angle itself. If theta is less than 10 degrees, then sine theta, it can be written as theta. Sine theta can be replaced by what? Theta. Hence, the restoring force acting on simple pendulum, F is equal to minus mg into theta. Minus mg into theta. Now, we know that pahilyas topic madhe tumhi shikle asel. हा एस आहे, हा अँगल थीटा आहे आणि हा काय, हा आर रेडियस एस आर ऑफ अ सर्कल. एस इज इक्वल टू आर थीटा, मीन्स थीटा इज इक्वल टू व्हाट? एस डिवाइडेड बाय आर. नाउ अप्लाई दिस हियर, थीटा इज अँगल, दिस लिनियर डिस्टन्स एक्स, अँड एल इज व्हाट? रेडियस. So theta must be equal to, as per this, theta, that is angular displacement theta is equal to, theta is equal to x divided by L. So theta is equal to x divided by L. It means restoring force acting on simple pendulum is F equal to minus mg into, now in place of theta I will write x divided by L, minus mg into x divided by L. Remember, mass of pendulum, acceleration due to gravity at that particular place, and the length of simple pendulum, these three physical quantities are constant for a given pendulum. It means that the restoring force acting on a particle is directly proportional to displacement, and negative sign indicates that force and displacement, they are oppositely directed. Here force is directed towards the mean position and displacement is measured away from the mean position. And by definition, a particle which is acted upon by a force which is directed towards mean position and its magnitude is directly proportional to displacement of particle from the mean position, that particle is said to be performing simple harmonic motion. So here, when pendulum has given a small amplitude of oscillation, then the motion of pendulum is linear simple harmonic motion. Motion of pendulum is what? Linear simple harmonic motion. It means, as we have proved, that simple pendulum is performing SHM when amplitude of vibration, amplitude of oscillation is small. Then what will be the time period of simple pendulum? Time period of a particle performing linear SHM is given by T equal to 2 pi divided by omega. Or as omega square is equal to k by m, omega square is equal to k by m, omega equal to under root of k by m, m is equal to kx, k is equal to m by x, m is equal to ma, m is equal to what? M by A. Therefore, W or omega, which is equal to under root of K by M, is equal to under root of K, in place of K, F by X, upon M. M means F by A. So this F gets cancelled, or omega equal to under root of A divided by X, or is acceleration per unit displacement means time t is equal to 2 pi upon under root of acceleration per unit displacement. Time period of a simple pendulum, t is equal to 2 pi divided by under root of acceleration per unit displacement. Now look at the expression for restoring force acting on a simple pendulum. What is restoring force acting on simple pendulum? Restoring force acting on simple pendulum is F is equal to minus mg into x divided by L. Or, as F is equal to ma, therefore F by m is equal to a. Force is equal to mass into acceleration according to Newton's second law of motion. So F by M is equal to A. So this equation now becomes F by M, divide both sides by M, or take this M in the denominator. F by M is equal to minus G into X divided by L. What is F by M? Is acceleration, and that is equal to minus G into X divided by L. Or in magnitude, A by X is equal to G by L. Magnitude only. What is A by X? It is acceleration per unit displacement. Acceleration per unit displacement, and that is equal to G divided by L. A means acceleration, X means displacement. A upon X means acceleration per unit displacement, and that is equal to G divided by L. Therefore, the time period of pendulum T is equal to, time period of simple pendulum T is equal to 2 pi divided by under root of acceleration per unit displacement means under root of, what is the acceleration per unit displacement? It is G by L. It is what? G by L. Or it can be written as T is equal to 2 pi under root of L divided by G. T is equal to 2 pi under root of L divided by G. And because frequency is nothing but L is equal to reciprocal of time period. But time period is 2 pi under root of L by G. So N which is equal to 1 by T is equal to 1 upon 2 pi upon into under root of G divided by L. So we are having the two expression, and one of the popular expression, it is the time period of a simple pendulum. Now from the expression T equal to, or as far as this expression for time period of simple pendulum is concerned, we had derived this expression for time period of simple pendulum as T equal to 2 pi under root of L by G. Derivation of this expression, it is based on three basic assumptions. First assumption, that the amplitude of oscillation of pendulum is very very small as compared to that of length of pendulum. अतः amplitude of oscillation लहान है as compared to length of pendulum. म्हणजेच काय? This amplitude of oscillation it is 20 times smaller than the length of pendulum. Second assumption, length of pendulum L, it is very very large as compared to that of amplitude of vibration. And the third and most important condition, that this pendulum is allowed to oscillate in one and only one vertical plane. Pendulum is oscillating only in what? One and only one vertical plane. So T equal to 2 pi under root of L by G, this derivation is based on three assumptions. First, amplitude of oscillation is small compared to that of length of pendulum. Second, length of pendulum is large compared to that of amplitude of oscillation. Third, pendulum is allowed to oscillate in one and only one vertical plane. Now from the expression for time period, we can have four laws of simple pendulum. Now the first law states that T is directly proportional to L. What is the first law? From this expression we can draw four conclusions, and each conclusion is nothing but law of simple pendulum. So first one is, T is directly proportional to root L. This is known as law of length. And how to read it? Time period of simple pendulum is directly proportional to square root of length of simple pendulum. Time period of simple pendulum is directly proportional to square root of length of simple pendulum. Dusra law hai, T is inversely proportional to root G. Time period of simple pendulum is inversely proportional to square root of acceleration due to gravity at that place where that pendulum is oscillating. Time period of simple pendulum is inversely proportional to square root of acceleration due to gravity at a place where pendulum is oscillating. Third, time period of simple pendulum is independent of mass of a ball. Time period of simple pendulum is independent of mass of a ball. And the fourth one and the most important, that time period of simple pendulum is independent of amplitude of oscillation. This law of simple pendulum, it is also known as law of isochronism. So this is all about simple pendulum. In board examination, there might be a separate question that prove that the motion of pendulum, simple pendulum, is linear simple harmonic motion when the amplitude of vibration or amplitude of oscillation is very very small. Or you may have to write down the time period of simple pendulum, and from that expression for time period, you may have to write these laws of simple pendulum. So this is all about simple pendulum. Now, what is Second's pendulum? In board examination, always there will be a question for 2 marks on Second's pendulum. So, as far as Second's pendulum is concerned, it is a simple pendulum whose time period is t equal to 2 seconds. What is Second pendulum? A simple pendulum having time period t equal to 2 seconds is called Second's pendulum. We know the expression for time period of simple pendulum, t equal to 2 pi under root of L divided by G. So, time period of Second's pendulum, t equal to 2 pi under root of length of Second's pendulum, L suffix S upon G. Now, squaring on both the sides, before squaring, for Second's pendulum, as t equal to 2 seconds, therefore 2 equal to 2 pi under root of ls divided by g. This 2 get cancelled with 2 and squaring on both the sides. So 1 is equal to pi square into ls divided by g, or length of Second's pendulum is equal to acceleration due to gravity g divided by pi square. By using this expression, if we know the length of Second's pendulum, then we can find out the acceleration due to gravity at that place. Or if we know the acceleration due to gravity at a particular place, then we can find out the length of a Second's pendulum.